Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I'm going to show you a time-saving shortcut for balancing acid-base reactions. An acid-base reaction is one in which an acid, like nitric acid, reacts with a base like sodium hydroxide to give us water and salt, in this case NaNO3. You can balance this the same way that I teach in the other balancing videos on my website, leiaforsci.com/reactions, where we write a checklist down the middle for all of the atoms present in the reactant and products. The problem is similar to what we saw in the last video on balancing combustion, where an atom that shows up in more than one place can be very confusing. In combustion, it was typically oxygen, but here, notice we have oxygen in both the acid and the base. We have hydrogen in the acid and the base. Same thing in the products. What you want to recognize is that in an acid-base reaction, not every single atom actually reacts. Not everything changes. So if you can identify what doesn't change and just keep it as a unit, the entire process becomes simpler. Think about what you have in your acid. An Arrhenius or Bronsted-Lowry acid is simply an H+ bound to some conjugate, in this case NO3-. An Arrhenius base is simply an OH- bound to a spectator ion, in this case sodium. The other thing to recognize is that our acid has a polyatomic ion, nitrate. Nitrate does not react or change, it's simply something that dissolves in solution so that we have nitrate in the reactants and nitrate in the products. So instead of breaking it up, what if we just pretend that nitrate is an atom, and when balancing, we'll simply look for how many NO3- appear in the reactants and products. Sodium is not a polyatomic ion, but it's also something that doesn't change, which leaves us with the oxygen and hydrogen. We have the acidic hydrogen, which is different from the basic hydrogen, to give us water. But what if we don't look at water as a brand new molecule? What if we look at water almost like the H+ cation bound to the OH- anion and balance them separately? That means we're going to look for the number of acidic or purple hydrogens and the number of basic or green hydroxides, discounting the fact that they both have hydrogen because we're looking at them separately. Let's start balancing. How many acidic protons do we have? We have one in the reactants for nitric acid and one in the product as part of the HOH. We have one nitrate in the reactants and one nitrate in the products. We have one hydroxide in the reactants and one hydroxide in the HOH of the products, and sodium 1 and 1. Look at that. There's one of everything. This reaction happens to be totally balanced. So we have 1 and 1 reacts to give us 1 and 1. I realize it appears to have taken more time in this simple example, but watch how much time it saves us for something more complicated. If, for example, we're asked to balance the acid-base reaction of phosphoric acid reacting with calcium hydroxide to give us water and the salt Ca3PO4. Soon as you identify that this is an acid-base reaction, identify your acidic, basic, and polyatomic components. Identify your acidic hydrogen and basic hydroxide. Identify those same components as the HOH in your products. Then look for any polyatomics. In this case, it's phosphate, so we're going to treat phosphate as a single unit. This allows us to write a very simple list. We have the acidic hydrogen, the phosphate anion, we don't even need the charges because we're just looking for whole numbers, the calcium cation, and the basic hydroxide. Now let's balance. On the reactant side, we have 3 acidic hydrogens, 1 phosphate anion, 1 calcium, and 2 hydroxides. In the products, we have 1 water molecule, which is 1 HOH molecule, 3 calcium, and 2 phosphate anions. Let's start with a non-water anion and cation first. We have a 1-to-2 ratio for phosphates in the reactants and products, so let's double the phosphates in the reactants, placing a 2 in front of phosphoric acid. That doubles my acidic protons from 3 to 6 and gives me 2 phosphates. I have 1 to 3 calcium in the reactants and products, so let's triple the reactants by placing a 3 in front of calcium hydroxide. Updating all the numbers, that gives me 3 calcium and 3 times 2 for 6 hydroxides. Phosphate is balanced, calcium is balanced. The only thing left unbalanced is that I have 6 acidic protons and 6 hydroxides in the reactants, but just 1 and 1 in the products. Well, 1 to 6 ratio, just multiply by 6. If you place a 6 in front of the water, that means I have 6 HOH molecules in the products, giving me 6 protons, 6 hydroxides, and look at that, 6 hydrogen, 2 phosphate, 3 calcium, 6 hydroxide. Everything is balanced. Let's update. We have 2 phosphoric acid reacting with 3 calcium hydroxide to give us 6 water plus 1 calcium phosphate. Once you're comfortable with this, I challenge you to redo this problem using the method of writing out every single atom, then coming back and letting me know in the comments if the shortcut saved you any amount of time. And then be sure to join me in the next video where we look at how to balance redox equations. You can find that video along with this entire video series, practice quiz, and cheat sheet. First, give this video a thumbs up, then visit my website, leahfrisai.com/reactions, for the MCAT stoichiometry and reactions practice quiz and cheat sheet. The link again, leahfrisai.com/reactions.